all those who are in the front lines of this pandemic. Thank you. This is the Philippines.
Buhay!
We are ANC.
Good morning, I'm Mikey Oreta here. These stories that made it to ANC's rundown. Former Philippine Senator Bongbong Marcos is expected to be nominated as the presidential bet for the political party founded by his father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos. But the young Marcos says he's still undecided. The Philippine Elections Commission is open to extending voter registration for another week as the September 30th deadline nears. And some areas in northern Luzon are back under a stricter quarantine classification due to an uptick in COVID-19 cases. The Kilusang Bagong Lipunan, or KBL, political party is expected to declare Bongbong Marcos, the son of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos, as its presidential candidate for the 2022 elections. However, Marcos himself was not at the event currently being held in Binangonan, Rizal. Instead, he is at an online news forum where he says he is still finalizing his plans for next year's polls. The KBL was founded by the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos before the end of his regime. Since its founding, though, the party has lost every single election, except, of course, the one back in 1981, where Marcos won as president. Vice President Lenny Robredo is still trying to unite the broader political opposition for the upcoming national elections. Robredo spokesperson, Attorney Barry Gutierrez, says that talks between the Vice President, Senator Manny Pacquiao, and Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Domagoso continue, even if the two have already declared their respective presidential bids. This comes amid public clamor for Robredo to finally make up her mind and to seek the presidency. But as early as now, Gutierrez says that Robredo supporters are already preparing for her candidacy.
She's serious about the responsibility of forging a broad coalition. It's not indecisiveness. In fact, it's the exact opposite. She is very decided that this is the way to go. This is the best way to go about it. The Liberal Party has been continuously organizing. It has continuously been preparing its own, well, admittedly limited machinery. Aside from LP, in the last three months or so, there have been a lot of volunteer groups that have come forward, individual citizens that have organized themselves to push for a Lenny Robredo run, and they're also moving. So it's not as if everything is in a state of stasis, like a suspended animation, while the vice president has yet to make an announcement. It's very clear to me that as soon as she makes the announcement, everything will be ready to go.
Meanwhile, 2022 presidential candidate Isko Moreno reveals that Vice President Lenny Robredo never asked him to run as her vice president. This comes amid speculation there could be last-minute substitutions for his tandem with his running mate, Dr. Willie Ong. Domagoso also shot down reports that Senator Grace Po will eventually file substitution complaints to replace Ong.
Ayoko ng chuchubibo ng buhay, ha. Diyan nga tayo nagkaloko-loko, eh. Paplip-plap-plip-plap, pabago-bago. You know, the people needs some decisiveness, no? Yung tatakbo, hindi tatakbo, tapos magsiswitching. Eh, nabili na yun, eh. We don't want to do the same.
Meanwhile, Domagoso says that he will not stop the International Criminal Court from investigating President Duterte's bloody war on drugs if he is elected to Malacañang.
The rule of law will be observed under my watch. No, why not? Well, nothing, if there's nothing to hide, we can gain also some level of respect in our neighboring countries, and makita nila that we are certain about our rules. Bakit naman hindi? Did that in Manila. War on drugs. Inuhuli namin mga suspect, dinadala namin sa husgado. Kinikilala namin yung trabaho at karapatan ng husgado at kinikilala namin yung karapatang pantao ng suspect.
The Commission on Elections says that they're open to extending voter registration for just one more week after the filing of certificates of candidacy for the 2022 polls. The voter registration period is set to end on September 30th, but there are bills pending in Congress seeking to extend this until October 31st. Many civic groups have also called for an extension. The Comelec reiterates, however, that further prolonging the process will only disrupt other preparations for next year's poll.
December 1 to 15, for the EMS configuration removable. So that is our concern. And considering that many of our people already suffered, even we have casualties because of this pandemic.
The poll body will also be suspending the issuance of the voter certification from September 27th until the end of the month so that they can focus on voter registration. That is, they expect people to flock to the Comelec offices as the deadline nears. President Rodrigo Duterte's net satisfaction rating drops from 79% in November of last year to 62% in June of this year. That's according to the latest Social Weather Station survey. Results from the June 2021 survey show that 75% of the respondents were satisfied with Duterte's performance, while 13% said that they were not. 12% say that they are undecided. Now, it's worth noting that this is a double-digit drop from Duterte's previous net satisfaction rating in November of 2020, which peaked despite the pandemic. Back then, 84% said that they were satisfied, while 6% said that they weren't. 9% were undecided. In other news, the provinces of Abra and Bohol, as well as Baguio, are placed under the general community quarantine with heightened restrictions amid an uptick in COVID-19 cases. Malacañang says that this will stay in effect until the end of the month. Under the stricter guidelines, dine-in services, personal care services, religious gatherings, and outdoor tourist attractions will be allowed to operate at a limited capacity. But even before the tighter quarantine was announced, the province of Benguet, where Baguio City is located, had already imposed stricter health protocols. Benguet was earlier flagged by the OCTA research group as an area of concern.
So essential travel na tayo yung ginagawa natin. Nag-check na sa border yan, kaya yung pila namin na mga sasakyan mahaba na.
Kung pwede po, itantan muna ang pag-travel dito sa Benguet. Itong mabilis ang pagtaas ng kaso ng COVID, for our safety din naman po.
The quarantine classification in Ilocos Norte, however, has been de-escalated from a modified enhanced community quarantine to a general community quarantine. Now, Meralco will resume disconnection activities in Metro Manila next week. This after the capital region shifted to a looser pandemic alert level quarantine system. But the electricity distributor assures the public that those under the granular lockdowns will not be affected by these disconnection activities. Disconnection activities will also be suspended in Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, Rizal, Lucena City, and Quezon, as these areas are to remain under a modified enhanced community quarantine until September 30th. Over 728,000 additional doses of Pfizer-BioNTech's COVID-19 vaccine arrived in the Philippines Thursday night. The National COVID-19 Task Force says that more than 90,000 of these vials will be sent to Davao City, while 51,000 doses will be allocated for Cebu City. With its latest shipment, the Philippines has received a total of 67 million vaccine doses so far. Over 15 million additional doses from several manufacturers are expected to arrive this month. As of September 22nd, over 19 million Filipinos have been fully immunized against COVID-19. Now, an advisory panel from the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention is recommending booster shots of Pfizer's COVID vaccine for a select group. This recommendation comes for Americans ages 65 and older, and some adults with underlying medical conditions, leaving out adults who live or work in institutions at high risk for COVID-19. The CDC's decision comes a day after the U.S. Food and Drug Administration also authorized booster shots for the elderly. Now, this paves the way for the possible rollout of booster shots as soon as this week for millions of people who had their second dose of the Pfizer shot at least 6 months ago. The World Health Organization is recommending the use of Regeneron and Roche's COVID antibody drug cocktail for high-risk patients. The treatment has already been granted emergency use authorization in the United States, having gained attention when used to treat former President Donald Trump after he contracted COVID-19 last year. Britain also approved the therapy last month, while other European regulators are still reviewing it. The World Health Organization's recommendation comes as they seek to improve global access to the drugs. They also called on Regeneron and Roche to lower their prices and to distribute the treatment equitably worldwide, especially in the low and middle-income countries. Tedros Ghebreyesus is poised for a second term as the head of the World Health Organization. Tedros was nominated by at least 17 European Union members. He also has the support of countries in other regions. Some diplomats told Reuters that they were unaware of other names being put forward, suggesting that Tedros will stand unopposed in the May election. Under the World Health Organization's process, envelopes are to remain sealed until after October 29th, meaning they cannot be ruled out that a country might nominate another candidate. Now, a former health and foreign minister of Ethiopia, Tedros was elected as the WHO's first African director general in May of 2017. He has led the global fight against this COVID-19 pandemic, steering the agency through attacks on its handling of this crisis. We're taking a quick break. Still to come, authorities scramble for answers surrounding the death of artist Bree Johnson. That story and more up next on The Rundown. Please stay tuned. Welcome back. Philippine police released CCTV footage that could provide leads to the death of the young Filipino contemporary artist Bree Johnson. Rafi Santos has the details.
Police have released security footage showing Bree Johnson and Julian Ongpin outside their rented room in La Union on September 18. According to the police, it is clear from the video that the pair had been arguing and were drinking alcohol sometime before Johnson was found dead. An earlier forensic report stated her case of death as asphyxia, with Ongpin claiming she had killed herself, which the victim's family denies. PNP Chief Guillermo Eliazar says the security footage and testimony from the hotel staff were now part of the investigation.
That is just one of the videos na nakita sa labas. Remember that the CCTV ay nasa labas, hindi naman siya nasa loob. So what happened inside ay wala pa tayong conclusion.
Eliazar says Ongpin told investigators he forced through a bathroom door to get to Bree, leaving him with wounds on both his arms and back. No signs of struggle found on Honson's body, except for a ligature mark on her neck.
One thing that they explained is that pataas kasi yung markings nung ligature. So pataas siyang paganon. So most likely, talagang pataas siya. Pero yun nga, pwede naman kasi pataas na nakahang, pwede rin pataas na inangat, di ba? So all of these things are being considered during the conduct of the investigation.
However, lawyers representing the victim's family are contesting the statement, saying forensics found other marks on Honson's body. The police say they are not yet ruling out foul play in the young artist's death. Meanwhile, the NBI has also conducted its own autopsy on Honson's cadaver and are now awaiting its results. They've also begun talking to the victim's friends and relatives as part of a parallel probe requested by Honson's family. Rafi Santos, ABS-CBN News.
Manila's ranking slips in the list of top 100 emerging global startup ecosystems. Startup Genome's 2021 report shows the Philippine capital placing within the 91 to 100 rank, meaning it's at the earliest stages of growth. In last year's report, Manila was within the 31 to 40th rank. Mumbai, meanwhile, topped that list. The report says that Manila's strengths are in financial technology and e-commerce and in its wealth of affordable talent. The Trade Department says that they will work hard to improve the Philippines' startup ecosystem. And that was the rundown. I'm Mikey Oreza. We'll be back with more news at 11. Please stay safe and see you back here then.
This is the Philippines.
Mobility will be key to recovery because we have relaxed some of our quarantine methods now, and we have allowed more transportation to come out. That's going to prove to be better for demand. If we do follow the health protocols, the ability of people to move around will likely contribute better to growth.